Hi guys, welcome to my channel Blend by Neesh. In case you haven't noticed, this is not me, this is Sonam Kapoor, and in today's video I'm going to be recreating this makeup look right here, which she wore to the Cannes Film Festival this year. The makeup was done by Namrata Soni. I love it. I think it's super chic and super wearable, which is why I chose this look. So let's not waste any more time and let's get right into it. So I'm keeping a photo of Sonam Kapoor's makeup on my phone next to me so that I have a reference as I go along. I'm gonna start with the Smashbox Photo Finish Primer Oil. I have super dry skin, so this works great because it acts like a moisturizer and a primer. But if you're someone who has really oily skin, then you can go ahead and put a mattifying primer instead of an oil. I'm just gonna really carefully and deeply massage it into my skin, and I'm gonna be really thorough because I don't want any patches of oiliness left on my skin. Next, I'm gonna go in with the Miss Claire Born to Glow Illuminator, and I'm just gonna pat that into the high points of my cheek. This is gonna give me a glow from within sort of look, and that's something that Sonam had because her skin looked super natural, and that's the kind of look I'm going for as well. I'm also gonna put some on the bridge of my nose, on my chin, as well as my forehead, to give that glowy, illuminated skin look. Now I'm going in with the Maybelline Fit Me Foundation in the shade 310. I'm taking a little bit out on my makeup tray. Like you can see, I'm just taking a tiny amount, and I'm using my YBP Makeup Perfector sponge to dab it all over my face. Now I'm gonna go in with very light layers. This is a full coverage foundation, but it is a great foundation because it does leave your skin actually looking like skin at the end. So I'm just carefully blending it into my skin as much as possible. You wanna take your time, go in very light layers, and really work it into your skin to give you that very natural skin-like finish, yet make your skin look flawless at the same time. Now I'm gonna go in with the LA Girl Pro Conceal HD Concealer in the shade Medium Beige, and I'm only gonna conceal the parts of my face that need to be concealed. So here you can see I'm applying it under my eyes to cover my dark circles, but I'm not making big triangles, I'm not drawing lines across my face. I'm only gonna put the concealer where it needs to be put, and then I'm gonna blend it out with my beauty sponge. Now, as you can see, this was the first time I was using this concealer, and I was super impressed with the way it completely erased my dark circles. This is a really good concealer and I would recommend it to everyone. Now I'm just gonna add a little more to the areas around my mouth as well as some acne scarring that I have in order to even out my skin tone even more. So again, just a tiny amount where you need to conceal and then blend it out with the beauty sponge. Remember guys, less is always, always more. Now I'm gonna set my makeup using the L'Oreal True Match Compact in the shade Golden Beige. I'm taking it on this big fluffy brush. I'm gonna tap off the excess and put a very light layer of powder all over my face so that my foundation and my concealer are completely locked and held into place. Now I'm gonna move on to brows, but first, a bit of an eyebrow dance. I'm gonna use a spoolie to brush out all my hair before I actually go in with product. I'm using this dark brown shade from the Nudes palette by Maybelline on an angled brush, and I'm just gonna carefully fill in the parts of my brows that need to be filled in. I'm not gonna go in with a heavy hand, and I'm not gonna change the shape of my brow. You wanna follow the direction of your natural hair growth. So for example, in this front section, my hair grows upwards, which is why I'm gonna push my brush in an upward direction. Now I'm just running the spoolie through my brow again to brush it out and make it look natural. So that you can see, that's the brow that's been done and that's the brow that's not been done. Time for eyes. I'm going to use a Jaclyn Hill X Morphe palette. I love this palette, and I'm going to start off with that light brown mustardy shade. I'm using my MAC 217 blending brush to apply the product all over my crease. Like you can see, I'm going in circular motions, and I'm not going too high up into my brow, and I'm not putting it on my eyelid. I'm placing it, concentrating it only on my crease, which is basically the socket of your eye, like the hollow part of your eye. Now I'm taking this dark brown shade on a smaller blending brush, and I'm placing it very carefully only in my crease and nowhere else. This is gonna give my eye a bit more depth as well as a bit of a gradient. Now I'm using that golden shade on this flat thin eyeshadow brush, and I'm just gonna pat it all over my eyelid. I don't want the color to be too intense. I just want a bit of a wash of a gold shimmer all over my eyelid. Now I'm going to mix both of these darker brown shades on a soft angled brush, and I'm just going to fake an eyeliner with that eyeshadow. It didn't seem like Sonam had anything intense going on in terms of eyeliner, but she did have some kind of brown smokiness there, which is why I'm going to apply the eyeshadow on my upper lash line as well as my lower lash line in order to create that hint of brown smokiness. And I'm just taking a clean brush and softening the whole thing out because we don't want any harsh lines. Now I'm using the Color Bar eyeliner. It has a super pointed tip, which is perfect for this look because I don't want a thick eyeliner. I'm going to create a very, very thin, almost invisible eyeliner, keeping it really close to my lashes just to give that slight hint of blackness on the top. And now moving on to Kajal, I'm using the L'Oreal Kajal Magique Bold and I'm going to put it on my lower waterline. And as you can see, I'm also going to tight line with this Kajal, which is putting the Kajal on the inside part of my upper lid. Now I'm going to mix two mascaras. I'm using Maybelline the Falsies Push Up Drama as well as the L'Oreal Volume Billion Lashes. I'm just doing it on my lower lash line first and then I'm going to curl my eyelashes using this Oddbow Eyelash Curler. You want to be careful when you're curling your eyelashes, girls. Do not yank your eyelashes out. Now, as you can see, I'm going to start from the roots and wiggle my way to the top. And I'm going to spend my time and coat every single lash. Next, I'm going in with the Estee Lauder Bronze Goddess. Sonam didn't seem to have a super heavy, sharp contour going on. So I'm just going to brown up my face very lightly, just to add some definition. For blush, I'm using the Miss Claire Professional Palette. And I'm going to go in with that pinky and peachy combination. I'm just going to add a bit of it to the apples of my cheek very lightly just to give it that healthy flush, and I'm going to drag it back upwards to blend it in with the bronzer. Time for highlighter, and I'm going to go in with my current favorite, the Hyper Real Glow by MAC. I'm using the first shade, which is a yellowy golden shade. Sonam had a very natural glow going on. She didn't have that banging highlighter that we see on Instagram nowadays. So I'm going to add a very little amount to the high points of my cheek and then use my finger to blend that out even more. I'm just going to add a little more to the tip of my nose as well as to my Cupid's bow. And now for the star of the show, the lips. Sonam had a really pretty orangey red shade going on. So I'm going to line my lips first with this orange lip liner by Miss Claire. I'm going to outline my lips and then use the same lip liner to fill in my lips as well. Filling your lips with liner before applying your lipstick will help your lipstick last way longer. And now I'm topping off that orange with my favorite red from Kiko Milano. I'm just going to dot it all over my lips because I don't want the red to overpower the orange. So I'm just going to add a slight bit of the red to the orange lip liner to give it the actual color we're looking for. And finally, to complete it, we're using the Miss Claire Soft Matte Lip Cream in the shade 44 and putting a very light layer on top of our previous two colors as if two colors weren't enough. And we're done. This is the final look. Obviously, Sonam has much longer hair than I do, so she had curled the bottom of her hair and left it open. But this was my take on Sonam's look. I really like how it turned out, and I think it's so wearable and so chic. Even if people like you and me don't have a red carpet to go for, it's perfect for so many different occasions, and I love it. So let me know what you guys think, and I'll see you in the next video. Don't forget to subscribe.